Let us see how to eliminate the left recursion from a grammar. So it is elimination of left recursion in a grammar, of left recursion in a grammar. Okay, so assuming that we have a grammar like this, S derive SA slash B. Now in this grammar, we already know that there's a left recursion, and we have seen an example of this. Because of this S, there's a left recursion, and this case is calling itself. Now you can use this as a formula, or you can use this as a rule. That means whenever you get a left recursion like this, you can also convert the grammar something like this. S can derive B S dash, and this S dash can derive epsilon slash A S dash. Use it as a formula, and this S dash is a separate variable. Instead of writing S dash, you could have also written something like this. S can derive B capital A, and this capital A can derive epsilon slash A A. So this S dash is just representing a separate variable. Okay, so you know, if we eliminate the left recursion, then one variable contains the right recursion, right? Because you can see, we cannot completely eliminate recursion. Recursion will be there definitely, because we have to generate the same sentence again and again. But if you eliminate the left recursion, then there's at least one variable which is containing a right recursion, which is containing a right recursion. Now let us see a few examples of left recursion. So I'll give you some examples. I'll give you some grammars, and you have to eliminate left recursion from those grammars. So the first grammar is something like this. E can derive E plus T slash T. T can derive T star F slash F, and F can derive ID. Assume this is a given grammar. E can derive E plus T slash T. T can derive T star F slash F, and F can derive ID. Now for this, you can see what are the locations where we have left recursion. Here we have left recursion. Here we have left recursion. We have to eliminate this left recursion, and for elimination we are going to use this particular formula itself. Okay, so let us take the first production, and it is E can derive E plus T slash T. Okay, and you compare the first production with this case, and you have to write it like this. So therefore you can write it like this. E can derive this complete statement. In this complete statement, E plus T slash T, right, in this entire statement, you can clearly see that this is recursion. So this is representing S, and this is complete representing A, and this is representing B. I'm comparing it with this statement. Okay, so this is representing S, this is A, and this is B. Therefore you could have written it like this. S can derive B S dash. Okay, so you can also write the same sentence like this. E can derive T E dash, and this E dash can derive epsilon slash A S dash, that means plus T E dash. Okay, you can write this entire sentence into this form. Okay, and the same way, you can also eliminate left recursion from this sentence. This sentence is like this. T can derive T star F slash F. Now in this entire statement, you can see because of this there's a recursion, and this entire statement can also be written as S. This is representing A, and this is representing B. So I'm comparing with the original statement. Therefore you can eliminate left recursion in this manner. We can say T can derive F T dash, and this T dash can derive epsilon slash star F T dash. Epsilon slash star F T dash. This is representing T dash. Okay, so this is how you can eliminate left recursion from this particular grammar. Therefore, the new grammar which we got after eliminating the left recursion can be written as E can derive T E dash, E dash can derive epsilon slash plus T E dash, and then T can derive F T dash, and this T dash can derive epsilon slash star F T dash, and this F can derive ID. Because in this F can drive ID production, there is no left recursion which is involved. Okay, F can drive ID, there's no problem with this particular statement. Okay, so this is how you can eliminate a left recursion from this. See, when we eliminate a left recursion, it does not mean that we are going to change the meaning of the grammar. Simply, you can also see it like this. So I think I missed this in the previous case. So let me show it to you. That means if you have a production like this, S can derive SA slash B. And you know this particular production is representing a grammar B A star. We have seen this in the previous case. And we know that we converted this grammar to a right recursive grammar, and we have given something like this, S can derive B S dash, and this S dash can derive epsilon slash A S. Now if you try to generate strings from this grammar, then let us see what are the strings which we are generating. If we generate a string of length 1, then it can be written as S can derive B S dash, and this S dash can be placed by epsilon, so it is B epsilon, which is B itself. This is a string of length 1. If you try to generate string of length 2, that can be written as S dash can derive B S dash. This S dash can be represented by A S, this is S dash, and this S dash can be represented by epsilon, so B A. If you try to generate string of length 2, that can be written as S dash can derive B S dash. This S dash can be replaced by B A S dash. This S dash can be replaced by B A A S dash. And further, this S can be replaced by epsilon, so it is B A A. Therefore, the string which we are generating, there is also B A star. Right, so even if we eliminate the left recursion from a left recursive grammar, and we get a right recursive version of this, still it is not going to change the meaning of that particular grammar. Okay, so let us take one more example of how to eliminate left recursion from a given grammar. Assuming that we have a grammar something like this, S can derive bracket L closing bracket slash A, and this L can derive L comma S slash S. Assuming that we are having this particular grammar. Now in this grammar, on the first statement here, there is no left recursion. No left recursion, hence there is no problem with it. Okay, in the second statement, you can see there is a left recursion and we have to eliminate this left recursion. And we know the formula, and according to the formula, formula which we have written in the previous case, so this can be written as L can derive S L dash, and this L dash can derive epsilon slash comma S L dash. Okay, and we are going to use this statement and we are going to combine these two statements. Hence, the grammar we are going to get can be written as S can derive opening bracket L closing bracket slash A, L can derive S L dash, L dash can derive epsilon slash comma S L dash. This is the final grammar which we have after removing the left recursion. Okay, let me take one more example of this. Assuming that we are having the grammar S can derive A, this A can derive AD slash AE slash AB slash AC, and this B can derive B B C slash F. Okay, now in this grammar you can see here there is no problem of left recursion, but here with this production there is a problem of left recursion, with this production there is a problem of left recursion, and with these two production there is no problem, and with this production there is no problem. Only these two productions are creating issues for us. Okay, so we are selectively, we are going to just take these two productions, and accordingly we can eliminate the left recursion from this particular grammar. Okay, so let us see. This grammar can also be written like this, S can derive A, because it was not creating any issues. So for this, see, generally when we remove this left recursion, then you know the statement is like this, S can derive AA slash B, something like this, right? So here we need to have something. In the same way, here we need to have something. Therefore, with these variables, with this one, I'm going to associate this one, and with this one, I'm going to associate this one. Okay, or you can, you know, change it. With this AD, you can associate AC, or with AC, you can associate AB, doesn't matter. So you can also write this particular grammar like this, and this A can be written as A capital B A dash slash A C A dash. And this A dash can be explained like epsilon slash D A dash slash C A dash. And this B can generate B B C slash F. Now you need to identify how we got this one. Just try to understand this, how we got this one. Okay. So I think Okay, fine. So let us take a few more examples of left recursion. Assuming that we have a production like this. S can derive AA slash B. A can derive AC slash ST slash epsilon. Okay, now here you can see because of this one, this one is calling this one and this one is calling this one. Okay, that means there's indirect recursion, and this kind of statements are called as indirectly left recursion. Then substitution in one variable, and then we are going to remove it, then we'll be removing it. Let us take an example of this. Assuming here we have statements like this. This one is calling this one itself, so we are just going to substitute the values of this. That is, we are going to substitute the values of S here. So for this you can also write S can derive AA slash B, and this A can derive AC slash AAD slash BA slash epsilon. Okay, let me explain it to you again. Here, because of this statement, there is a left recursion, but it is an indirect left recursion. In the previous case, there was a direct left recursion, but now there is an indirect left recursion. That means indirectly, it is going to call itself. Now, for this one, we have to replace this S with these values. That means if you remove this S, we replace it with AA, so it can be written as AAD. If you replace this S with B, so it can be written as BD. So I'm going to replace it with the original values, and I'm going to write like this here. And here you can see I have eliminated the indirect recursion. Now, after eliminating the indirect recursion, now you can clearly see there's a clear left recursion here. There's a clear left recursion here, and now you can remove this left recursion very easily. So after removing this left recursion very easily, like this, this entire statement can also be written like this. S can derive AA slash B, A can derive BD A dash slash epsilon A dash, and this A dash can derive epsilon slash CA dash slash AD A dash. So you can write it like this. Okay, I hope how to eliminate left recursion, this topic is now clear to you. Next topic is about left factoring. That is, what is left factoring and how to eliminate left factoring from a given grammar.